In this video, we're going to talk about some capabilities around stopping, pausing, or debugging tests in Testim. So before we begin, we're going to make a few assumptions that you have an account, you've logged into Testim, and you've gone ahead and created a few tests. So let's get started. So we can see here that we have a test in Testim, and let's go ahead and actually run this. So let's say as this test is running, something came up and I actually want to stop the test from running. I can just click this icon right here. You can see it says stop run and it'll stop the test from running. Okay, pretty self-explanatory there and why you would want to do that. Another scenario that would come up would be, you know, maybe I wanted to actually set a breakpoint. So obviously in software development or coding, you know, maybe you'd want to set a breakpoint. And what's going to happen is if we run this now, we set a breakpoint right before a certain step. So right before we actually log into the product, we're going to set a breakpoint. So the test is going to stop. Okay. So we can see it's reached the breakpoint. And now what I can do, maybe the use case for this, where maybe I want to inspect something on the screen that may be happening. Maybe I want to actually change something in the configuration. Really flexible in how you do that. But if I just click on run test, the breakpoint will continue and this test will continue to run. This is a login test and it's going to loop through several different users. And as you can see here, it's going to stop at that breakpoint with each time because we set the breakpoint, but right before the login. So I'm going to click stop. And again, when you set a breakpoint, if you want to go in and what you'll want to do is remove it. So we'll toggle it to remove the breakpoint. And the final thing to show here is there's an option here to run locally step by step. So if I pick this option, once the test starts running, we can see that I can actually pause the test from running if I want to do that. And then if I can continue it, and it will continue and it can go ahead and play the next step. So I have the ability to do that as well. So each of these could be used in a different scenario for a particular different reason. But again, they just give you more flexibility in terms of troubleshooting or debugging tests, whether you want to stop, pause, or set a breakpoint. So hopefully this provided some overview on how to use some of these different options and some of the benefits and why you would do it. Go out to the website or reach out to us if you have additional information.